Macmillan Audio presents The Character Edge by Robert L. Caslen, Jr. and Michael D. Matthews. Narrated for you by James Lurie, with an introduction from the authors. Forward. This audiobook catapults General Robert Caslen and Professor Michael Matthews into the front rank of the legion of people now working on good character across the world. Part of the reason for the success of this audiobook is the character and hugely different experiences of the two people who wrote this gem. I want to tell you about each of them. I first met General Caslen when he was the brigadier general who had just taken his new assignment as commandant of West Point. I was a visitor, lecturing to the cadets about resilience and post-traumatic growth. We met to discuss the future of his counseling service. General Caslen was concerned that the counseling service was exclusively occupied with bad stuff, drug abuse, low-level criminality, and sexual harassment. Couldn't counseling do better than just this, by giving advice and measuring the good stuff as well, he asked, like how to become an exemplary soldier or how to make academic choices based on one's strengths, not just how to be less bad. I could see that we were on the same wavelength. His interest was military excellence and academic excellence, and so was mine. My specific interest there was in transforming counseling services and psychology generally into being about what makes life worth living, as opposed to just how to deal with the negative stuff and with the bad apples. So he and I talked about the possibility that the counseling center could be a place where cadets find out about the best things about themselves. I left the meeting thinking, this guy is a visionary. Fast forward a few years later, General Caslen has now become the superintendent of West Point, the officer in charge of the whole shebang. As you will hear, the theme of his tenure was the building of character. His many years of experience in the field at every level of command had taught him that building character is the cornerstone of military leadership. And this is what he brings to this audiobook. Thousands of hours of actual leadership, ranging from in extremis on the battlefield to the more pastoral setting of West Point. His partner in this audiobook is Professor Michael Matthews, a scholar, researcher, and teacher of long experience. I first met Mike more than 15 years ago when I was organizing the future of positive psychology. We invited Mike to become a senior fellow for several months at the University of Pennsylvania under a grant from the John Templeton Foundation and Atlantic Philanthropies. Angela Duckworth and I had just begun to work on grit, and Mike and Angela began a collaboration with West Point to study who quits the academy after Beast Barracks, the grueling summer program that new cadets face as their first introduction to the Army. Grit proved to be a significant predictor of not quitting, and this expanded into Mike's work on character as a predictor of military success and also launched Angela's remarkable career. So what Mike brings to this audiobook are serious behavioral science, rigor, and many years of experience teaching and measuring the minds and behavior of cadets. As you will see, this results in a unique, unprecedented collaboration between a member of the highest ranks of military leadership with a lifetime of extensive experience in instilling character in soldiers in the field, with a senior behavioral scientist experienced in measurement and experimental design. So you have in front of you the first audiobook on character resulting from a partnership between long experience with the reality of the battlefield, combined with long experience in behavioral science. Joining two good heads together is only a potential, but the actuality is an audiobook on character that they and the entire field can be proud of. I'm going to avoid spoilers in this foreword, but I want to tell you what I liked the most. Duty, honor, country is the traditional motto of West Point. But merely mouthing that motto over and over does not translate it into the actions of its graduates. It is Caslen and Matthews' insight that the molding of character during a cadet's 4 years at West Point transforms the words of the motto into a lifetime of noble deeds. How this is achieved, how this is measured, and how it applies to the world beyond the Army is the treat that awaits you now. Martin E.P. Seligman, Professor of Psychology, Director, Positive Psychology Center, University of Pennsylvania. Preface. The character edge springs from more than 80 years of collective experience by the authors. General Caslen served in the Army for 43 years following his commissioning as a second lieutenant from West Point in 1975. From second lieutenant to lieutenant general, he commanded at every level from platoon to division, in peace and in war. As a second lieutenant, Caslen was part of an army recovering from the Vietnam War, an army plagued with racial unrest, drug use, and a lack of purpose and direction. Caslen, with the help of his generation of Army officers, helped repair the fractures plaguing the Army and helped prepare it for the first Gulf War and for the wars in Afghanistan and Iraq that followed the events of September 11, 2001. Caslen capped his distinguished Army career by serving as West Point's 59th superintendent from 2013 to 2018. Throughout his years in the Army, Caslen observed leaders and soldiers in the most challenging situations. It became clear to him that character and leadership were inextricably linked. From his perspective as the leader of a platoon of 30 soldiers to a division of more than 23,000 soldiers, it became evident that character was essential to winning. As his views on the essential role of character in leadership developed, he came to prioritize character development, both his own and that of his soldiers, as a core component of his leadership philosophy. This culminated during his tenure as West Point superintendent, when he formalized character development as a primary institutional goal along with cadet academic, physical, and military development. Dr. Matthews, born the same year as Caslen, brings a different perspective to the character edge. A military psychologist for 40 years, Matthews employs scientific methods to study character and its influence on individual performance and leadership. Both a former law enforcement officer and Air Force officer, he is keenly interested in the ways that character may be measured and how it interacts with other factors, such as intelligence, in influencing how we adapt individually and lead others in challenging, sometimes dangerous situations. He is interested in the theory of character and its relationship to other important psychological and social attributes, but he is also interested in how character plays out in the types of real-world situations that Caslen has experienced throughout his long and distinguished Army career. Like Caslen, Matthews believes that character forms the basis of leadership, as well as being of fundamental importance in personal adjustment and social relationships. Retired generals have written many books on these topics, just as psychologists have written many books on leadership and character. Those books in the first category are based on the unique experiences of the leader and lack a foundation in behavioral sciences. While often insightful, such books are easily criticized as presenting simply opinions. Leadership and character books written by psychologists, on the other hand, are well-grounded in the behavioral and social sciences. Scientifically sound, they may lack relevance. Things that work well in the laboratory often fail to play out in the real world. The purpose of the character edge is to blend together these two complementary perspectives on character and leadership. No other audiobook on character and leadership is based on the combined experiences and perspectives of both a strategic leader and a scientist. We weave together the science and practice of character and character-based leadership into a narrative that both educates and inspires listeners. We frame this preface with two stories, one written by General Caslen and one by Dr. Matthews, that illustrate our passionate interest in character and leadership. Iraq, 2009. Lieutenant General, retired, Robert L. Caslen, Jr.
On February 9, 2009, during Operation Iraqi Freedom, the 3rd Battalion of the 8th Cavalry Regiment was securing the western part of Mosul, Iraq, as part of the famous surge. Coalition casualties and enemy contact had dropped significantly throughout most of Iraq, but northern Iraq, specifically Nineveh province with its capital city of Mosul, was still seeing frequent combat. Lieutenant Colonel Gary Derby, a tough, no-nonsense, scrappy officer both loved and admired by his soldiers, had been in command of the battalion for a couple months, and already significant progress was being made under his leadership. A soldier's soldier, Derby led from the front, and through his constant presence and authority, he continually brought his troops confidence, hope, and optimism, regardless of whatever challenging circumstances they were facing. At about 1 o'clock in the afternoon on February 9th, I received the call that no commander ever wants to receive. En route to a combat outpost in western Mosul, Derby's vehicle was hit by a suicide vehicle-borne improvised explosive device. Derby, 3 other soldiers, and 1 interpreter in his vehicle were instantly killed. With a heavy heart, I immediately got into the helicopter and flew to the battalion headquarters to meet with his surviving leaders, to console and put my arm around them, and to assure them that our division and the rest of the theater leadership would do whatever we could to assist them through this loss. I promised to get another commander for the battalion as quickly as possible. Lieutenant Colonel Derby's impact on the culture and values and effectiveness of his unit was obvious not only by the gains he had made in the field, but also by the shock his loss had on his soldiers. A leader's influence is significant, and I learned through my career that in settings of crisis and stress, this impact is exponentially higher. In dangerous conditions, people are drawn closer as they sense their vulnerability. They are more attuned to the actions of their leaders because they must depend so heavily on them for guidance through the perilous circumstances. The glue that holds these people together is their trust in their leader. Trust. Perhaps the most important ingredient in effective leadership. Is arguably the most important quality fostered in troops by their leaders. The love and respect the troops had for Gary Derby was in great part because he delivered for them again and again. Their trust was about as high as one can imagine. They would follow him anywhere because they trusted he would lead them safely and competently. Where was that trust engendered? In part, it came out of the competence that Gary Derby demonstrated every day as a battalion commander in combat. But trust is also built on something that is as important as competence, and that is character. Quite simply, you can be the most effective and competent battalion commander in my division in combat. But if you fail in character, you fail in leadership. Lieutenant Colonel Gary Derby showed the highest qualities of character. He was honest, he was selfless, he was full of grit and determination, and he was compassionate. His character came through in subtle ways and in less subtle ways, but it was obvious. He listened to his troops' concerns, demonstrated care for each and every one of them, and put his life on the line for them. It was the basis of his troopers' trust in him. When Lieutenant Colonel Derby was killed, the soldiers in the unit were not only grieving over the loss of a friend and comrade, they were mourning the loss of someone they trusted with their lives. They felt rudderless without him. I knew they needed a good leader, and fast. Western Mosul was a critical location in the fight against radical Sunni Islam, and we needed to get this battalion emotionally sound and back into the fight as quickly as possible. Working with the commander from the 1st Cavalry Division, we had to find a capable officer who we could quickly place in charge to lead Derby's battalion. Fortunately, a good candidate, an officer who was already selected for battalion command, although scheduled for a year later, was already in theater. He was tough, personable, and accepted by the battalion's leadership. He quickly proved through his competence that he would be an effective leader in this critical location in western Mosul. The new battalion commander had been in place for only a couple months when I received a call from his supervisor, the brigade commander, about an issue that needed to be resolved. As I listened to the brigade commander's report, all I could do was shake my head. Gary Derby created a culture of honor and integrity so that when leaders in his unit saw something out of standard, they chose to confront and report it. This was the case when these leaders saw something going on with their new commander that they recognized as being outside the values and character of their unit. The new commander had developed an inappropriate online relationship with the spouse of a staff officer. Some of the senior leaders had observed the online dialogue, and they immediately knew it was wrong. One of the hardest things a subordinate can do is to report a leader's alleged misconduct. But that is what these leaders had to do. When the brigade commander reported the allegations to me, I initiated an investigation. While the investigation was going on, we temporarily suspended the new commander and sent him home. And sure enough, the investigation substantiated the allegations. And this new commander was relieved of command. That this commander was a highly competent leader did not make him effective in practice. Time and again, I'd seen that no matter how competent you are in the skill set demanded of your high position, if you fail in character, you fail in leadership. Shortly after the new commander was sent packing, I went on patrol with the battalion for a day. The soldiers were out of uniform, the non-commissioned officers were not making corrections, and disrespectful comments were made over the radio that we were all able to hear. It was concerning. The 3rd Battalion, 8th Cavalry Regiment had suffered the loss of its trusted and competent leader, Gary Derby, and then the loss of its moral compass when the character defects of Derby's replacement. The battalion would continue to work hard at its mission, but it was never the same. Quite simply, the failure of character and leadership not only has an impact on the individual, but also a significant impact on the climate of the organization and its ability to accomplish its assigned task. In combat, a unit with a defective organizational climate because of character, failure, and leadership has impacts not only on mission accomplishment, but also the lives of each and every subordinate.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.